Hello and greetings from Iceland. I'm starting this update with a little teaser from Mother Nature. And this has nothing to do with a volcano. This is just a rare phenomenon here in the north at this time of year. And we call it the sun. And we are glad to have it back. So the days are getting longer, finally. But as for the eruption that should have started already, I'm going to make this simple. The ground has already lifted around 5 cm above the critical point that led to the forming of the magma dike in November and the eruption in December. And even our most careful professor has been saying this has to come up any day now. And in the meantime, the Blue Lagoon has opened up and some of the nearby hotels, so experts seem confident that the eruption will occur at the same place. We see more and more people getting back to Grindavík now, but the town is however still closed for tourists like me, and a restaurant owner was complaining in the TV tonight, saying that he would like to welcome us all, but is it safe, and I'm somehow more worried about the Blue Lagoon and the power plant than the town. After all, we have this big magma chamber there underneath three layers of aquifer systems. So I've asked myself every now and then, can the magma come in contact with those aquifer systems, and what then? We are, however, not seeing any serious earthquake activity now, and in the news it's mostly repeated content like this must be coming up any day now. And this morning a journalist picked up a story from a volcano blog owned by Mr. Haraldur Sigurdsson, volcanologist. I've mentioned him before, and like his colleagues, he can get things wrong from time to time, but he has the guts to speculate, and I respect that. And he also tends to get some of his long shots right. And this morning he was saying that a large magmatic intrusion, about 50 to 100 square kilometers in size, may have formed under the Krýsuvík area. And if that's the case, we might just as well get an eruption there. So it's a long shot for sure, but good enough for me to work with, since he's talking about the area where most of the earthquakes in the Krýsuvík system have been taking place for a long, long time. And the land uplift was detected there in 2022, but we were so busy waiting for the eruption that we somehow forgot all about it. Scientists were, however, talking about it back then, that a large part of the peninsula was actually lifting, and then we got this extremely small eruption from that strange scenario that was in no way consistent with the earthquakes and the land uplift, or just like the mountain that was in labor, but only gave birth to a mouse. So what Mr. Haraldur Sigurdsson seems to be indicating is that the current events are just a sideshow, little leaks, and the worst has yet to come. And I've heard that one before, and it's of course not for me to say if it could be right or not, but this might however explain the earthquake swarm near the Krýsuvík area that the Met Office tends to say is triggered by other systems. But I think that the history is saying something completely different. We can look this area up, back in time, day by day, hour by hour, and we see that earthquakes there by the lake is nothing new. So could it be that the Krýsuvík system is just a way bigger player in all this? I think it's a worthy question, and this area, Lake Klevarvatn, and the nearby explosion craters are some of the most exciting formations on the peninsula. Like the explosion craters alone are a sample of what groundwater can do. And there is even an old caldera buried somewhere under there. So is this area waking up big time? But it might be that only time can tell. So let's check out the earthquakes near the island Grimsey by the north coast. The Arctic Circle runs across this island. I'm around 80 kilometers away from this area. And this is a very well known earthquake zone that I've talked about from time to time. It's called the Tjörnes Fracture Zone. It might be that there is some growing tension there, but in June 2022, earthquakes were found all over the north for several weeks, which is very unusual, but lucky us, it was not on the most dangerous part of the Fracture Zone, but you do know that there is enough tension there for a magnitude 7 earthquake, and this town, Húsavík, was flattened twice in the 1800s, and we can see the fault where it runs through the town. And if you want to know more about this, I have a long video online and linking to it where I cover this in details. and what we see now on the seismometers is nothing new or unusual. This will most likely fade out, but I wanted to mention this because unusual earthquakes are in my comment section, often before I see them in the news or on the earthquake pages. And I'm getting ready to drive south to Reykjavik and the peninsula. All batteries are charged and ready if the eruption should start in the next days or hours. But if not, I have some work to finish before I take off. But as soon as it gets colder again, I'm on my way, since I do have some tasks for the thermal drone, which I have to finish regardless of an eruption or not. So I can promise you an update on the story about the highway that's been warming up. But as for Grindavík, the tension just keeps on growing, and I'm leaving links to all the webcams that are up and running, and sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.